Tell me a little closer so you can, that mic can pick you up. All right, we got a responder here. It says, when you eat something, your body processes this information, thereby causing an effect on the body, unless I'm misunderstanding your definition. I said there are no clinical studies that prove causation between a macro count and desired effect, okay? Macro count, as in how many grams of protein does Brad over here need per day to put on muscle? And we're gonna try to predict. Let's say 1 pound of muscle a month, okay? Which is reasonable, all right? He's 215 pounds. Let's use their mysterious formulas, which are unproven, never been proven anywhere in any lab. There are weak correlations. We're going to go into observational studies there and how bad those are. I'm talking about causation, okay? What's the number? What's the formula? He says they have equations for this, hence why I can cut 500 calories and lose weight, which is a lie. You cannot cut 500 calories and lose weight. This has never been proven in a clinical study, not once. All those studies that try to prove caloric deficits work, not a single participant, real human being, proved that this works. Okay? This goes back to real metabolic physiology, not pseudoscience. How do we store fat? Just repeat what you said earlier.
Insulin.
Glucose goes in the bloodstream. Pancreas produces insulin. Okay, insulin binds to the fat molecule. Glucose from the bloodstream goes in the fat molecule. You get fatter. We're talking about glucose. Insulin. Fat storage. Okay? If you're in a hypothetical 500 calorie diet, which you can't measure, this guy cannot measure it, because first of all, you have to know how much you're netting. You eat 40 grams of steak. How many grams of protein are you netting? What's the bioavailability?
No idea.
I'll tell you what, it changes from person to person. It's gonna be different from each person. So these equations that they have for this shit is based on averages. Nobody's average. Who conforms to the BMI chart? It says I'm morbidly obese. What does it say about you, Brad?
Obese.
Okay. What does it say about you, Dan? Hmm? The BMI chart?
Right on.
Have you ever looked at it?
I'm obese.
Okay.
Oh, I'm super happy.
Yeah. So you can't go off of these equations that they have for shit because they're based on human beings that don't exist. Crazy averages that are severely outdated, too. Like the average. Like, what is it, 9 calories and a gram of fat? That's the average. A gram of fat from peanuts, or a gram of fat from steak, or a gram of fat from avocados. It's the average how many calories you absorb from these sources. It's just an average. So some food source to food source, it changes. You might get 9 calories from avocados, and you get 3 calories from steak fat, depending on who you are. It changes. So if you're going to try to hit a caloric deficit, good luck. It's not going to happen. It's nowhere near the number you think it is. Okay? So those equations are horrible. They're as bad as the BMI chart. It says, so your just eat when you're hungry model, this sort of works and makes sense to keep it simple. It sort of works. It works for 200,000 years. There's 200,000 years of evidence that eating when you're hungry works, okay? Our body is super smart. It has hormones, leptin and ghrelin, that says it's time to eat. You can't outsmart that signal. You can't do some fancy nutrient timing and think you're gonna outsmart your body and get it to do crazy shit, okay? It worked for 200,000 years. We survived the harshest environments imaginable on the eat when you're hungry plan. Okay? Make sense? So it sort of works. Just eating when I'm hungry, wouldn't it be very accurate? The thing is, your body doesn't care about accuracy. It just cares about enough. How do you know when you have enough?
Full.
You're not hungry anymore. You're full. Eat till you're full when you're hungry. Eat till you're full when you're hungry. Your body only cares if you have enough. It doesn't care about tiny little number adjustments that don't even exist. Does that make sense? Because we're going to always wrap back around to weight loss and how mystical this is. When you, at first, you got to say, what causes weight gain? It's not calories, it's not equations, it's not anything mysterious. It's dumping too much glucose in the body, spiking your insulin, causing energy storage. All right? Does plants and animals cause energy storage? Excessive amounts? Does it bring you above your baseline? Okay, here's your insulin over here, and your baseline is here. You're producing that much insulin day in and day out on shit you can find from the forest. Okay? Now, introduce the 80s with Kool-Aid Man busting through the door. Boom. Insulin levels have risen. Had nothing to do with calories. We didn't all of a sudden, as an entire planet, decide we're going to start overeating and not moving. Blue-collar jobs still exist. Guess who's morbidly obese? People with blue-collar jobs. So their activity is good. All right. Did all of them decide as a team? Did they unite? Did they get a union going of overeaters? No, that's silly. We can't unite on shit. It's like we argue about everything. All right. This is the only thing we united on. With the rise of sugar, obesity went up. We bring this back down, what's going to go down with it? Obesity. And that's why big sugar companies are fighting us tooth and nail. I went on a huge long rant with 400 tangents there. Did anybody keep up with that? All right, good.
Got you.